Hey friends, it's Leanne here. I am back with another CGM update. It's week number 3. I've learned a whole bunch more, including what happens to your CGM when you have an IV infusion. For those of you who are new around these parts, my name is Leanne Vogel. I blog over at healthfulpursuit.com and you can watch some of my CGM videos. I will include links down here and also down up here and also down below. I have been wearing this bad boy. Oh my gosh, I only have a couple days left. I can't believe it. I can't eat. Oh, what an experience. I feel like it's been such a gift to wear a continuous glucose monitor for the last 21 days. I've learned a lot about myself, a lot about what to do and not to do as it relates to my glucose, and how important it is for us keto folks to really understand what our glucose is doing. Now, again, if you are new to glucose monitoring and you're not really sure what this continuous thing is all about, I will include my previous videos up here and down below if you want to start from the beginning and work your way forward. I'm currently uploading a bunch of YouTube videos on my computer, so you can probably hear the fan, but this is unedited, uncut, just me and the camera and you. So if you can hear the fan, well, just be excited, there's more coming soon. Okay, in last week's video, I chatted about the metabolic rate on the CGM, what my thoughts were about it. So I'm specifically using the Levels CGM and the Levels app. So I'm gonna explain, because I've been getting some questions about what all this means. So a continuous glucose monitor goes into your arm. Now, this is a continuous glucose monitor from Abbott. And so Levels writes a prescription for you that you then receive 28 days of monitors. That's two monitors. You replace them every 14 days. You get these two monitors. You insert the first into the back of your arm, kind of in your tricep area, and then you download the Levels app, and the Levels app allows you to see how your metabolic rating is for the various things you're doing. So when you eat, you mark down what you eat. You know, I had flatbread with pesto and chicken, and then it gives you a 2-hour window, okay? It gives you a 2-hour window between the time you ate to that 2 hours and what your food did to your glucose during that time. Now, a couple of problems with this is that your life is not in a vacuum. You know, if you go for a walk directly after you eat, that's going to affect it. If you sit down, it's going to affect how you digest your food. If you're in a really stressful environment, I did that test for a couple days actually, during a very low cycle day, like cycle days 3 to 7. I ate the same food every day and then changed my environment around me. So on the first day, I ate in a calm environment, did a day of like yoga and chilling. And then another day I worked nonstop, recording videos, podcasts, all the things, and really allowed myself to get stressed and to just see the difference in my glucose was really helpful. Now, the Levels app is not going to show you, like, it's just going to give you a rating. So after those 2 hours, it's going to say, like, your rating is 3, or your rating is 7, or your rating is 10. Now, 10 is the best. And you'd be surprised, you know, some of the keto meals that I thought would be so incredibly a 10 were like a 5 because I included something else. So it's been really fun from that route. But if you're new to continuous glucose monitoring and even the concept of monitoring your metabolism, you're probably going to get hung up on this for the first little while, just as you start to learn how it works. And to get to my IV experience, so every couple of months, if I'm feeling kind of like flat, or I know that my cortisol is getting a little bit too high, I'll go into my doctor and get an IV. Generally, it has things like B12, magnesium, zinc, glutathione, vitamin C, and a couple of other things. So I had Jada poke me with a needle. You can still see the little mark right here. And it's on the same arm. I don't know if that made a difference, but I marked in my Levels app IV, and within about 20 minutes of my IV starting, my glucose went up to 500 plus, and it was like, hi. And then it took me about 24 hours to get back to normal. Now, I haven't done any research on why this could be. My initial thought would be that I just pumped my body full of glutathione and vitamin C, and there was vitamin D and a bunch of other things that my body probably couldn't, or rather the CGM couldn't tell the difference between monitoring the glucose in the cells and the IV that I was getting. So I thought that maybe I damaged the monitor. Thank goodness it's back to normal and things have been really good. But even seeing how having an IV now 24 hours later, my glucose is a lot more stable. So all these little things are helpful. And what I love about the Levels app specifically is it gives you that metabolic rating and you really start to understand what activities and what foods give you a better rating. Now, the problem with this also is that for women specifically, we are going to react to different foods at different times depending on our cycle. Now, the app doesn't go through that, so it's really up to you to understand how this works. I educate women in my six-week weight loss program. I'll include a link up here. There's currently a wait list on that, and I will get back to you when things are all sorted out. But in that program, I do show you how to eat right for your glucose and for your hormones throughout your cycle so that you can really understand what's happening. And also, I'm guessing that if you're watching this, it's probably that you wanna lose weight with the ketogenic diet, so I show you how to do that. So that's one of the issues with the metabolic rate and the metabolic marker, is there's some items that just won't show, and it's up to you to really understand this. Now, if you're like, oh my gosh, I want a CGM, this is so cool, how do I get one? There are a couple of ways that you can go about this. Number one is I recommend working with Levels. So I'll include a link down below, which allows you to skip the list. I think there's like a 29,000 person wait list for this thing. It is crazy. And so you go through all the process. It's so, they hold your hand throughout all of it. They have a bunch of videos to show you how to put this thing in. I gotta tell you, the first time I did it, it wasn't a big deal. I didn't feel it. I was actually surprised. I had my husband do it because I was worried because it was a needle and I was terrified. But then the second time he did it and he put the needle in a different place and I definitely felt it. It was like tingling down my arm and I was fine. I didn't pass out, although I was laying on my stomach. But so they show you all of the ways that you can apply it, and then they hold your hand throughout the whole process. They send you your monitor and you get going. Now this service is a little bit costly, and so if that's not an option for you, you can always go to your doctor and see if you can get a prescription for a continuous glucose monitor. That will run maybe $60 to $90, so a whole heck of a lot cheaper, especially if you have insurance. However, you're not going to have access to the kind of app that goes to the details like Levels does. The Libre Link app is good-ish, but like you can't really track anything or monitor things as it relates to food, and you really have to like dig deep into the data. I've had to do this for a couple clients in the past, and although it's possible for me to do because it's like what I do for a living, I'm not sure that I would want somebody to go through it to that detail. So that's definitely something to think about. I've gotten a lot of questions about pain, and I talked about applying the second monitor and how it wasn't so great. I'm living, so it's fine. I didn't bleed out or anything. What the most painful part about wearing a CGM is taking this sticker off. Like, guys, it is, I mean, this has been on for like 8 days. I should probably replace it with the last sticker, but it is painful. If you are a man or you have like pretty hairy arms back here, I would highly recommend shaving or waxing before you do it, because like I couldn't imagine ripping that off with a lot of hair, and I don't have a lot of hair back there, and it was definitely painful to say the least. So if you have questions about CGM, continuous glucose monitoring, you want to ask me, next week I'm going to do a roundup 28 days summary of wearing a continuous glucose monitor from Levels. I'm going to answer all your questions. If you have any questions, you're unsure of anything, just post them down below in the comments and I will share them with you next week. Also, I just got a notice from the Levels team that they're going to give me another month. So I'm going to be taking off the rest of October into November. On November 8th, we're going to do an episode on the Keto Diet Podcast with Casey from Levels, chatting about how to work it and a bunch of questions. I had lots of questions, and we recorded this episode before I had a continuous glucose monitor, so I'm really excited to do another episode with her in the future now that I've worn it for a little bit. So I'll be reapplying another 28-day session to my life in about 30 days. I'm going to take a break, see how it goes. I'm going to feel like really naked without all the data. It's going to be super weird. So again, I'll be back next week with a Q&A. So if you have any CGM questions, put them down below and we will answer them. And thanks so much for hanging out with me. It's been a blast and I will see you around soon. Okay. Bye.